you. In the last few years, we did it directly in your shul. Now it's by Zoom. But, you know, when Hashem gives us something maybe that is not so happy for us, like this corona, so Hashem gives us also lots of medicines, like the Zoom. New options that Baruch Hashem, we can do things that we couldn't do before. And I believe that we have to try to take also a difficult situation and to try to turn it to an opportunity. To try to see things that we couldn't do before and we can do now. And the Zoom is one of those things. We can sit here and learn together. Everyone from his home. So, Bezrat Hashem, you will start learning. I'll share with you a PowerPoint. The PowerPoint will be in Hebrew, but the shiur will be in English. Don't be worried. You'll tell me when you see the PowerPoint. You see, it's okay?
Can.
Okay. I want to speak today on our special behavior on Aseret Yemei Tshuva. On Aseret Yemei Tshuva, people are more tzaddikim. They try to behave better. Is it good? Is it correct? Is it ideal? Or maybe it's like lying, like cheating. I suppose that everyone knows Nechama Leibovich. Nechama Leibovich, that wrote five books on the Torah and also lots of other things. Nechama Leibovich said, when I was a child, the Yalduti, I was told in school that I need to behave nicely, especially in Aseret Yemei Tshuva, between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. Now, she was a Yeke, you know, you'd understand. Shaldi et Ava Sheli, I asked my father, and he told me, it's true, you need to behave in a special behavior between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur. But you need to behave not less nice, exactly the same between Yom Kippur and Rosh Hashanah. And we understand that the father told her, all the year, you should be the same. Now it's interesting. It's a very interesting say what Nechama Leibovich says here, but when we check it, in the halacha, we can see a different system, a different idea. Shulchan Aruch, Or HaChaim, Taf Reish Gimel. Af mi she'eino nizhar mipat shel akum, ba'aseret yemei tshuva tzarich nizahar. Also, if you are not careful, from pat akum, you eat bread of goyim. On Aseret Yemei Tshuva, you have to be careful. And actually, our subject is to behave in a better way on Aseret Yemei Tshuva. Is it good, ideal, or cheating? So from one hand, it looks like cheating. It looks like cheating, lying. You should behave the same all the year. But from the other hand, we see here, the Shulchan Aruch ordered us Also, if you eat all the year bread of goyim, aser demei tshuva, be careful. There is a machloket. If you may eat bread of goyim all the year, and it's sugya in avodah zarah daf lamed hey, in shulchan oruch, in yore deah, kuf yud gimel, and shulchan oruch says here, okay, all the year you want to eat bread of goyim, pat aku, eat. But aseret yemei tshuva, you mustn't eat. Tzarich leizeir, you have to be careful. And it seems a little strange. The source of Shulchan Aruch is in Yerushalmi. Yerushalmi, Masechet Shabbat, Perik Aleph, Halacha Gimel. Yerushalmi says, in At yachol michul kol shat achulim letara echol. Rabbi Chia tells Rav in the Yerushalmi that if you can eat chulim all the year when you are pure, when you are tahor, better to do it. According to Halacha, just if you eat korbanot or truma or things like this, you need to be pure. And then just Kohen can eat it. Someone that is not Kohen, it's with Maiser Sheini, he goes to Jerusalem, he eats it pure. But if you eat chulin, if you eat just normal food like we have today, it's not Kodesh, it's not holy. You don't need to be pure. We are not pure today, and we eat all the time food. But Rabbi Chia told Rav, if you can be pure all the year when you eat chulin, although you don't need to do it, it's better. But then it continues and it says, Ve'im lo, if you can't keep all the year to be pure, you can't, it's too much for you. Tehe achil shiv'a yomin min shata. Be careful 7 days a year. What are those 7 days a year? So Rav Ya explained that those days are aseret yemei tshuva. And the Rosh, Rabbeinu Asher, brings Rav Ya, maybe I'll do it a little bigger. Okay. Yerushalmi, what we read right now. Perikama de Shabbat. Rabbi Chia Rabba mafkid l'Rav. Rabbi Chia Rabba told Rav, Inat yachol emeicha kula shata v'tara echol. If you can eat when you are pure all the year, eat. Ve'im lo, echol shiv'a yamim v'shata. If you cannot, at least 7 days a year. V'katav Ravi ha'ezri, Raviya, one of the Rishonim, wrote, קיבלתי שאלו 7 ימים שבין ראש השנה ליום כיפור. איה ומסורת, לדורזה 10 ימי תשובה. על כן נהגו באשכנז, אף אותן שאין נזהרים מפת שנוכרים כל השנה, ו10 ימי תשובה נזהרים. Because of this, in Ashkenaz, the minhag was 10 ימי תשובה, you do not eat pat aku. You don't eat bread of goyim. Also, if all the year you eat pat aku. And actually, we have to understand. Let's imagine that you are riding now in with your car, Jerusalem, Tel Aviv. You can ride 110, okay. Let's say you are riding now, not 110, you are riding 130, okay? Suddenly, Waze tells you, Shoter lefanecha, a policeman is in front of you. What do? You release your leg from the gas, you go maybe to 80. You go over, you pass the policeman. What will happen 2 minutes after you pass the policeman? You'll go back to 150 kilometers. And actually, it seems that we are doing the same in a certain way, tshuva. All the year we are riding 140, 50, riding high. A certain way, tshuva, we low, we go to 80, tzadikim, but we know exactly what will happen after a certain way, tshuva. And it seems not just like cheating, it seems also an emuna problem. Why? The policeman doesn't know what was before, what will be after. He doesn't know. So when you know it, okay, it can work on him. But Hashem knows exactly that all the year we are riding 140, that we behave not the best, and that we are going to do it maybe also afterwards. So what's the point to do in the middle something different? Hashem knows exactly. It seems as if Hashem doesn't know, and we now behave nicely because there's trial, and afterwards we'll continue in our regular way. This is my question, and I would like you to suggest answers. After I'll hear his answers, we'll try to go and explain them more. So I would like you now to try and offer suggestions as a Bakasha.
Can I say something?
Yes.
Okay. So kind of like Torah dibra bilashon b'nei adam, that the Torah has to sort of come down from its high level and speak to us in a way that we can understand. So similarly, these aseret yemei tshuva, we simply as human beings can't always live on the high level to which we aspire. And so we have these practice 10 days or these motivating 10 days that we try our best, and then we go back to being human beings, but maybe there'll be a residual good behavior after the 10 days.
So Barbara?
10, yeah.
Barbara says, we are just human beings. So we try our best. We can't continue all the year in the same way, but we are trying now, we are doing whatever we can do now. And because of this, on those 10 days, we'll have special behavior. Okay, maybe more people can offer.
It's better than nothing.
So you say it's better than nothing. You know, my mother was British, and sometimes when we did things that weren't so good, so she said, could be worse. So, okay, you say it's better, at least something. I mean, so you do something, whatever you can do. So it's also important. Toda, Paul?
Paul.
Toda. More offers, suggestions? Yeah.
Okay, so I have one suggestion. The Indian regarding eating pasakum, of course, is an Indian that is only relevant in Galut, because here in Eretz Yisrael, we live here, we're not going to be eating pasakum, right? We're not eating pasakum. It's not particularly relevant. So what meaning that if we make aliyah and if we live here in Israel, then we are more able to achieve that higher level. So that is perhaps, so the fact that chutznikim, a lot of them like to come to Israel during chagim, during the time between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, and so another regalim, what does it mean? It gives, so it's in order to draw them to that higher level, so they get a little taste during Aseres Yemei Teshuvah of what it is really like to really live a Torah life, which can only be done in Eretz Yisrael. And every time they come, maybe it spurs them on to maybe make a decision to actually live permanently in Medinat Yisrael. And therefore, that those 7 days can be an important influence from that perspective.
So, Harold?
Yes.
Harold. So, Harold is giving us, a tzioni tshuva. It would be good for Yom HaTzmaut also. You say, Eretz Yisrael, this is the place of every Jewish person. You should come, make Aliyah to Eretz Yisrael. Maybe it's not so easy, but you know, if you want to be holy, this is the place. Bat Akum is an example. It's not just Bat Akum. Don't continue living between going. Come to Eretz Yisrael and 10 days a year, you'll get a taste of like it should be the ideal in Eretz Yisrael. So toda for this unique answer. Bakasha,
yes. I'm just wondering, is Pat Akum a question of kashrus, or is it a question of just being more Jewish?
Okay, it's a good question. Pat Akum, we are not dealing on a question of kashrus. It's Pat Akum when you know that the goyim are bringing just kosher products inside, no shela of kashrus. The Gemara says that gazru pitam mishum bnoteihem. You'll be close to the goyim, in the end you'll marry them. And this is what the Gemara said. Be careful, don't be too close. You eat bread with Jewish people, don't be too close. And actually, there is machloket between Shulchan Aruch and Rama. How important is it to be machmir on Pas Akum all day when you know it's kosher? And in this, it's interesting. You know, usually, who is more machmir, Sfardim or Ashkenazim? Usually, Ashkenazim are more machmir, right? Usually. In this case, it's the opposite. Shulchan Aruch says you have to try not to eat Pat Akum, and the Rama is more making in this thing. You know, I got once a telephone call from someone, a teenager, says that he's in Nepal, and he says he's stuck, nothing to eat, but he has here going that he can buy bread in this place. I asked him, you know, it's kosher? He said, yes. And he said, what's to buy the bread? I asked him, are you Ashkenazi or Sephardi? So he was shaking, and he says, Ashkenazi, because he thought that Ashkenazi is always the worst answer to give. It's not a good answer. It's better to say Sephardi. He said, no, this time Ashkenazi is better. Ashkenazi are more maker, although in this case also the Shulchan Aruch would be maker if he hasn't got anything to eat, other thing. And in our case, so for Sephardis, it's more halacha not to eat all the year. Also Ashkenazi try to eat Bat Israel, but for Sephardis, it's really more chiyuv. So according to Shulchan Aruch, he says, at least try on a certain way to behave better. But really, it's not just Pas Akum, because this is just example.
Yeah.
The Poskim brought lots of other examples. Don't be angry those days. Don't be lots of other things, you know. So it's an example, but it gives us just the idea.
If we act in the correct way during these 7 days, maybe there's a chance that after the 7 days, we'll carry on acting in that way. Once you get used to doing things in a certain way, after a week, maybe you'll carry on and do them for the rest of the year.
So, toda, toda. Your name is?
Michael.
Michael. So, Michael says, and I see you wrote it also in the chat, Michael says, if we will behave better those 10 days, maybe we'll continue afterwards in the continuous of the year. Toda for this answer. Someone else wants to say something? Okay, so we'll continue. And I'll share back the PowerPoint. And I'll try also to bring also your answers and to add more answers. First answer I called here, Meniat Hidarderut. Meniat Hidarderut means that we have to stop from getting low and low and low and low. We have to stop it, that you won't be in the lowest level in your life. And I'll explain. 2,100,000 days passed be'erich from Briyat HaOlam. But if you look in the calendar, you won't find this date. Why won't you find this date? You won't find it because it's not practical. We count years, not days. But maybe it is another idea. A couple came to me and they called. The wife wants to paint the house every year. The husband says, what's the point painting the house every year? What's the point? Any case, in a few months, it gets dirty with the children. So what's the point to paint every year? I told them, I can't tell you if to paint every year, every 2 years, every 5 years, but from time to time, you have to paint. If you won't paint at all, in the end, your wall will be black. So from time to time, you need a new beginning. And actually, all the world has a new year, not now, but they have new year because everyone understands that he needs circles, he needs beginnings in his life. So we can understand that we have here a new beginning. So we try to behave better, but actually we know that it's not just something psychologist. Chazal tells us, V'chol musafim k'tiv v'hikravtem. Kan k'tiv v'asitem ishe. In all the korbanot, it's written, v'hikravtem, to sacrifice. But in Rosh Hashanah, it's written, v'asitem ishe. To do, to create. Why v'asitem? Ha'keitzad, amar nehem HaKadosh Baruch Hu l'Yisrael. Banai, ma'ale ani alechem, כאילו היום נעשיתם לפניי, כאילו היום בראתי אתכם בריאה חדשה. The Midrash says, קדוש ברוך הוא, it's not just psychologist that it's a new beginning. It's a real new beginning. He gives us a new notebook every year. We start from the beginning. And we can understand that we have this beginning to start every year, to be clean. And then also if in the year we'll have stains, we'll still stay in a reasonable place. If we would have this beginning, we would get down and down and down, who knows till when. We need a new beginning. A new beginning gives us the ability that also if in the end of the year we won't be the same, at least we'll be in a reasonable place. So maybe this is one answer for our question, Meniat Hidarderut. And I want now to give a second answer. A second answer, I call it היום אם בקולו תשמעו. I want to read with you something of Reb Nachman in Breslev. He doesn't speak on our question, but he speaks on something on all mitzvot, on all things. ליקודי מוהר"ן חלק א' סימן ר' ע' ב'. היום אם בקולו תשמעו, the Torah tells today, listen to my voice, Hashem says, listen to my order. זה כלל גדול בעבודת השם, שלא ישים לנגד עיניו, כי אם אותו היום. רב נחמן says, this is a big, big rule. When you try to change yourself, you try to be better, don't think on all your life. Think just on one day. Let's say you say, I want not to say anymore Lashon Hara. Don't think on all your life. Think on one day. Today. וכן בעבודתו יתברך. לא ישים לנגד עיניו, כי אותו היום ואותו שעה, he says, sometimes it's not just the day, it's even the hour. You say, okay, this hour I won't be angry. כי כשרוצים להיכנס בעבודת השם, נדמה להאדם, כאילו הוא מסע כבד, ואי אפשר לו לשם מסע כבד כזה. רב נחמן says, when you are trying to change, it seems sometimes, wow, it's so big, so heavy, how can I do it? So he says, try one day. Don't think all your life, think on one day. And if you think on one day, then you have the ability, Be'ezrat Hashem, to succeed also in the rest of your life. So this is the second answer. And I think this is what maybe Michael said before and others. We are trying in a certain way tshuva, and we can't speak on all the year. He says, okay, 10 days. 10 days we can handle. Ezrat Hashem. Maybe we'll see how to continue in the end of the year, continuous of the year. But we start with Hayom in the Kolot Shema, like one day, 10 days. If someone has here or questions or things he wants to say, so just interrupt. You are in Israel. You can just interrupt in the middle. It's okay. I want to give a third answer. The third answer, I called it, Hashem karov elein. Hashem is close to us. We have power. And I'll explain. Rosh Hashanah Adaf Yudchet Amud Alef. Dirshu Hashem v'yimatzeo elu asara yamin sheben Rosh Hashanah liyom ha-kipurim. The Gemara here says we have 10 days. That Hashem is close to us more than all the year. Dirshu Hashem v'yimatzeo, 10 days. Between Rosh Hashanah and Yom HaKippurim, Hashem is very close to us. And this Gemara has we can find the idea in Rambam, ילכות תשובה פרק ג' הלכה ד', נהגו כל בית ישראל להרבות בצדקה ובמעשים טובים, ולעסוק במצוות מראש השנה עד יום הכיפורים, יותר מכל השנה. We are trying to do צדקה and מעשים טובים between ראש השנה and יום כיפור, more than all the year. So also here Rambam says, like we saw in Shulchan Aruch, that we behave differently between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, more than all the year, you are doing tzedakah, ma'asim tovim, and mitzvos, more than all the year. And Rambam explains, in the in perik bet al chava af al pi shatshuva vehatzeaka davening yafe leolam, although always it's good to do tshuva, to daven, it's always important. Rambam says, ב-10 הימים, שבין ראש השנה ליום הכיפורים, יפה ביותר, ומתקבלת מיד, שנאמר, תרשו השם וימצאו. Rambam says, תשובה and תפילה always are important, always are good. But between Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippur, and 10 ימי תשובה, התפילה מתקבלת ביותר. Hashem accepts our תפילה more than all the year. And this idea we see in other places. There is a very famous mashal of Baal HaTanya, mashal HaMelech, HaMelech Basadeh, the king is going out in the field and everyone is close to him and he smiles to everyone. And we understand, you know, also a teenager came to me and said, Rebbe, I don't like Aseret Yemei Tshuva. I asked him why. He said, because it's frightening. It's frightening. We have to do this. We have to do this. I told him, really, Aseret Yemei Tshuva is a happy time. Of course, we try to work on ourselves. It's a big job and work. But we understand Hashem is very, very close to us. Hashem tries to help us. And because of this, we are happy that we have the ability to change when Hashem gives us the power. And this is this mashal, Lamelech Basadeh, the king comes to the field on Aseret Yemei Tshuva, והוא מקבל את כולם בסבר פנים יפות. הוא מראה פנים שוחקות לכולם. בעל התניא says, as if Hashem smiles to everyone. It's not that he comes here to frighten us. He comes here to be with us, to help us. And of course, we have to work on it. But we have koach when Hashem is close to us. And this idea is brought also by Rav Soloveitchik. Rav Soloveitchik says, אחותי נדהם, someone who has seen, he is so afraid, אני פחדן, חלש הנני, לא אוכל לעלות בהר השם, he says, I'm weak, how can I climb the mountain to be close to Hashem? עונה לו ריבונו של עולם, Hashem answers him, יורד אני אליך משמי שמי מרום, כדי להחיות רוח שפלים, ולהחיות לב נדגעים. I go down to help you. Don't be afraid. You're not alone. You're not alone. You're not weak. I'm with you. I'm giving you a hand. And because of this, maybe, on Aseret Yemei Tshuva, we have the ability to do more things that maybe all the year we don't succeed doing them. Because on Aseret Yemei Tshuva, Hashem is close to us. And when Hashem is close to us, we have the ability to do much more. And I want to explain a little more. In Shulchan Aruch, Siman Aleph, the Rama starts Shulchan Aruch and says, Shiviti Hashem lenegdi tamid, all the time you have to feel that Kadosh Baruch Hu, that Hashem is in front of you. And Rama says, in the name of Rambam, Moreh Nevuchim, that when someone all the time feels that Hashem is in front of him, he has no sin. Why? Why it helps us that we'll have no sin? So maybe the obvious answer is that if Hashem is in front of us, we are afraid. We won't have a sin because we are afraid. We see Hashem next to us. Second answer, the Rama gives. Rama says, "Miyad tagi elav boshto." Rama says, "It's not nice. You'll be the word is shy. You won't make a scene. It's not nice to make a scene next to Hashem. Not because you're afraid. It's not nice. You have busha." So this is another answer that the Rama gives. But I think that maybe you can give another answer. Okay, I call it Mashala GPS. You know what is GPS, like Waze? I don't remember when the GPS started. Maybe it was 15 years ago. I know how to drive if it's a way that I know very well, then I know what to do. If it's somewhere that I know very well, so then I can know how to drive. Or if I have a driver, or if my wife is next to me. If not, I'll go, you know, sometimes not in the right direction, places that I don't know. And once, around 15 years ago, I was asked to be a sandek. And a sandek in a place next near Hadera, I didn't know how to get but then I got the new GPS. I said, wow, I have GPS. So maybe I can manage there also if my wife is not next to me. I'll see how to go there together. I put GPS and they told me, Rebbe, there are twins. We wanted to be sandek of those twins. But please come on time. You know, rabbis always come on time. So I said, okay, I'll come on time. I have the GPS. I was there driving and then the GPS in the middle of the way says, Od 800 metrim tifnei yamina. 800 meters, turn to the right. Okay, 800 meters, I have time. I still continue, I have time. And then he says, in 500 meters, turn to the right. I said, okay, I have time. Then he says, in 200 meters, turn to the right. And then I see that I cannot turn to the right. There is a fence, like a wall. I can't, I don't know what to do. And I know, Rabbi, please come on time. Please come on time. I have those twins to be a sandek. And then I continued straight. I had no choice. But suddenly the GPS says, Mechashev Maslul Mechadash. I'm calculating a new course. Wow, I was calm. And he brought me another 2 minutes, 3 minutes, brought me again to the right place. And then I thought to myself, Lehavdil, of course, Elef Alfei Avdalot. But like Shiviti Hashem Lenegdi Tamid, when we feel Hashem in front of us, we have no sin, not just because we are afraid, and not just because of busha. We have no sin because when Hashem is next to you, you have koach. You know that also if you make a mistake, also if you drive straight instead to the right, if you want the help of Hashem, Hashem will help you. He'll bring you to the right place. You reach the right place in the end. And because of this, on those 10 days of Aseret Yemei Teshuva, Hashem is close to us. He gives us hand and he tells us, don't worry, you'll manage. You'll manage, I help you. And maybe because of this, we have a special behavior on those 10 days because we are now close to Hashem. Hashem helps us and we can do things that maybe all the year are more difficult for us. I'm going back to the PowerPoint. And I want to give a fourth answer. A fourth answer I called here Mashal Ha'armon, the Mashal, the example of the palace. And this is something that is a story that Baal Shem Tov says. I'm bringing you here the story, but it's lots of Hebrew here. It doesn't matter now. I'm saying the story in my language. Once was a king, and the king had a palace, a huge palace. Everyone wanted to go to the palace, but they understood they cannot go there. One day, the king says, everyone can go to the palace. Everyone can come. So of course, everyone wants to come. So everyone tries to come, and suddenly they see wall, mechitza. They see a wall. Okay, a wall, what do they do? So some of the people go back, and some try to climb the wall, to climb. And then they see frightening animals. They see dubim, they see bears. So lots of people are escaping. And some say to themselves, the king told us to come, we'll go. They go, and they see another wall, even higher than the first wall. And lots of people are going back home. Some people climb, they succeed climbing the wall. And then they see animals that are more frightening. They see tigers. And then people are escaping, and there's some are continuing, and they see another wall, even higher than the two first ones. And also people are leaving, few are continuing, and then they see lions and things more frightening. Everyone escapes, just one. Continues. He continues, and he sees another one. He climbs. It's higher. And when he cannot climb anymore, he sees the palace, and he tells the king, please save me, help me. And then, v'hesir ha'achizat enayim. What the king did? The king showed him that everything was virtual. There were no animals, no walls. Vayar she'en shum choma, ve'lo masach mavdil. Rak eretz mishor, ve'ginot, ufardesim. He sees trees and grass and music, klei oneg, v'sharte ha'melech. What is this mashal? I'm adding here another one. What is this mashal? The Torah tells us, Parashat Nitzavim, the Torah tells us, "Lo b'shamayim, lo me'ever la'yam." The Torah tells us on the mitzvos and on tshuva המצוות, התשובה, בתורה tells us, לא בשמיים היא, it's not in the sky, ולא מעבר לים, it's not overseas, לא רחוקה היא, it's not in heaven, not overseas, not לא רחוקה, כי קרוב אליך הדבר מאוד. The Torah tells us all the mitzvot are very, very close to us. When the Torah tells us this thing, why does she tell us? Because what everyone feels exactly the opposite. Everyone feels התחושה הטבעית. Our normal feeling is that המצוות, מצוות התשובה, our feeling is that it's very far from us. It's בשמיים, מעבר לים, רחוקה. So our feeling that the mitzvot are very far, it's very difficult for us not to say לשון הרע, not to be angry, to keep all the mitzvot, תפילה and צניעות, and all the mitzvot, it's very difficult. בשמיים, מעבר לים, רחוקה. But the Torah tells us, no, it's very close, it's לא בשמיים. לא מעבר לים, לא רחוקה. So we have to understand. It's close or it's far away. And according to Baal Shem Tov, you can understand. From one end, it seems to us that the mitzvot are very, very far away. And tshuva seems very far away. Why? Because to change, it's the most difficult thing in life. הדבר הקשה ביותר הוא להשתנות. To change, it's the most difficult thing in life. And it looks for us, how can we change? It looks, we have walls, animals, it's so far away from us. How can we change? The Torah tells us, look, it will be difficult. In the beginning, you'll have a wall and animals, and also if you succeed, another wall and other animals. It will be difficult. It won't be easy to change. But you have to know. In the end, when you'll reach the palace, when you'll succeed not to say lashon hara, and not to be angry, and to have tefillah, when you reach the palace, in the end, you'll feel, wow, this is my real place. Here, I feel good. The place that I was before, this wasn't my real place. All the walls, all the animals were virtual. It's not true. So from one hand, it's very difficult. It's not easy to make a change. But we have to know, in the end, when we succeed, we'll feel it's much better for us. And maybe Aseret Yemei Teshuva is the time to try to discover what is our real power. It seems to us very far away, walls, animals, we can't reach, no, no, try. You'll do it 10 days, and then you discover that it's so good for you. You discover new power. So maybe all this thing of a certain Yemei Teshuva and special behavior is to try to discover our power, our koach, our real power, to reach the palace. And then you'll see the things are much more natural to you. And this is what Baal Shem Tov said, Vesir achizat enayim. It seems that the mitzvot are far away. It seems that there's a wall between you and the mitzvot, a wall between you and a change. It's just achizat enayim. It's just virtual. It doesn't mean that it won't be difficult. And also, if you succeed in this all your life, you have more challenging and more walls in other issues. But when you reach them, you'll feel that this is the right place for you. And I want to explain a little more. And I want to get here to a fifth answer. The fifth answer is Ze be'emet ha'teva shelanu. What do I mean? We saw the example of the palace. In the end, we'll see that no walls, no animals. We'll see that it's good for us. Why? Because Hashem gave us all the mitzvot in a way that will be based and good for our nature. Chazal tells us that Kodesh Baruch Hu created the Torah and from this created the world. It means that we are created in a way that if we'll follow Torah and mitzvot, we'll do the things that are the best for us, that we'll feel the best with them. Maharal speaks about the Mishnah, the Braita, Aratza, Kadosh Baruch Hu, Lezakot et Yisrael, Lefichach, Hirva Lehem Torah Mitzvah. Hashem wanted to give us zchut, privilege. So he gave us lots of mitzvot. Why lots of mitzvot is zchut? Let's say that we would have, instead of 613, we would have 300. We could do the mitzvot much better. Why? Lots of mitzvot is zchut. Maharal explains, Hashem doesn't give a mission to someone that can't handle it. If Hashem gave us tariyag mitzvot, He gave us power to succeed with Tariyag Mitzvot. And it means that all the mitzvot is something that connected to us, brings us to be better people, happier people, to feel better. And someone can come and say, Rebbe, I understand what you say, but I don't feel like this. I feel that the mitzvot are not making me happy, not easy for me, not you know, in our generation, there's a very, very good example that we can answer this question. When I was a child, my father started eating healthy food. And why did he start eating healthy food? He started eating healthy food because my father, when he was 54 years old, he got a terrible heart attack. And the doctors told him that he has just 3 months to survive. And then they believed that after heart attack, you can't move, don't do anything, no exercise. And another professor came to him and said, I suggest that you'll exercise, you'll do things. And said, you have nothing to lose. They tell you that you have no choice in your life. Try. So he started. And he started walking, then he started running. And then he continued running 10 kilometers a day. He continued running from 54 till 86 and a half. He was running in competitions in Israel, in Chutz La'aretz. They have lots of articles on him. And I learned from him, first of all, what is a change? That from someone that doesn't do anything, started exercising every day and running. And secondly, I felt how good it made him. He felt in the beginning, wow, it's so difficult. And then he felt so good with it. And also he was eating just healthy food 3 times a day. Today, there is no problem to find the bread with whole wheat. But 40 years ago, it was very difficult. You know, it wasn't every store. I remember in Tel Aviv, I was going to find Dr. Wiesel, special bread was kemach maleh. You know, my father ate just kemach maleh. And people that start to eat healthy food, in the beginning, it's very difficult for them. It's very difficult. It's not tasty, they don't feel well with it. But after they get used to it, suddenly it becomes tasty and they feel good. They feel, wow, this is the good thing for us. Because they were used to junk food before, so it's difficult. Healthy food doesn't make you happier. But after you get used to healthy food, you feel, wow, this is the right thing for my nature. And then you feel good with this food. You know, someone came to me and said, Rebbe, I eat all the time chocolate. Do you have an idea how to stop eating chocolate? I told her, if you want to eat chocolate for 1 year, you won't search for chocolate anymore. It's not so easy 1 year not to eat chocolate, yes? But our body search for chocolate if he eats all the time, chocolate. But if you don't eat, your body becomes more healthier and he doesn't need it anymore. Rav Kook explained also example with sports. That Rav Kook explains when someone doesn't do sports and he starts, it hurts him in the beginning. But when it hurts you, it means that you didn't exercise for a long time. And afterwards, you'll find it, wow, you'll find it good for you. And the same thing also is the mitzvot. We are trying on those 10 days to eat, and I'm answering here to the question also in the chat. We are trying to eat healthy. We are trying to make all the mitzvot in the highest level. We know it's difficult for us because we are used to eat chocolate. I'm not speaking now about chocolate, just chocolate. Yes, it's an example. We used to eat chocolate, to eat tzeva ma'achal, color, all the bad things. Suddenly, aseret yemei tshuva, we have lettuce and cucumbers and everything healthy. Okay, it's difficult, but you'll know if you'll do all the mitzvot in a certain way, tshuva, you'll discover that what looks for you so far away, it's really close to you. This is your real nature. And according to this, I think you can say, and I'm putting again the PowerPoint. According to this, I think you can say that it's not that we are doing now something not natural, something, you know, like cheating, like putting a tachposet, a costume. All the year, we are not real. Aseret Yemei Teshuva, those are 10 days that we are trying to be real. All the year, we are not real. We are doing things that we are not really good for us. On a certain way, tshuva, we are reaching our real nature. So this is another answer to understand our behavior in a certain way, tshuva. I want briefly to add another two answers. I'll do it briefly. I know that we have just a few minutes. Another answer that I think that is true right here. On a certain way, Tshuva, we are trying to see what is our goal. What is our dream? Rav Kook explains that Tshuva is not to be complete. No one in our world is complete. Rota Tshuva, Perek Hei Vav, Rav Kook says, Ikar Yesod HaShlemut, Hi Ha'ariga VeHachefetz HaKavu El HaShlemut. What is Tshuva? Tshuva is to try all the time to be better and better and better. You won't be complete. But the dream, the goal, to try to be better, this is the main thing of Tshuva. And sometimes it's more important what is your dream than where are you now, where are you today? Of course, all the time you have to try to be better and better and better. But what is your dream? Do you dream just on, you know, to have more fun, to have more money, to have, or do you dream on high things, la'asot retzon Hashem ba'olam, dreams on chesed, on mitzvot, on, what is your dream? And we are trying on a certain way to understand the dream because we know we belong to the dream. This is our place. But all the time we are busy with small things, with other things. 10 days, try to feel the dream. And to feel the dream, Bezrat Hashem, will bring you every year to another step of this big dream. And I want to end with another answer. Let's say that someone, all Aseret Yemei Tshuva, didn't eat Pat Akum. He was a tzaddik, all Aseret Yemei Tshuva. In the end of the fast, he went out from shul and he sees a bakery of goyim. Wow, it smells so good. Ah, he breaks the fast on Pat Akum. So what will we say? We'll say, okay, you try. We thought that you are strong, but now we discover that you are weak. Really everything, all the certain Yemei Tshuva was for nothing. I think it's not true. First of all, you said before that it's better than nothing. Everything is important, but I think it's even much more. You haven't got a human being that all his life are in the highest level. You haven't got a woman that all the davening are like Rosh Hashanah, like Ne'ilah. But how miserable is a person that hasn't got highlights in his life? How miserable is a person that hasn't got tefillot of Rosh Hashanah, of Ne'ilah in his life? Also, if you won't be able to continue, if you brought your soul 10 days to this high level, this will affect your soul all the year. Maybe Pat Akum you'll eat, but other things you'll be better. Like you need vacation for your body, like you go to Beit Avraha, Beit Avraha is like hotel, that you go to rest, you need an hotel to your soul. Aseret Yemei Tshuva is hotel for your soul. Beit Avraha LaNefesh. You are trying to bring yourself to the highest level because you know that also if you won't be able to do it all the year, it will have an effect on all the year. I'll give you an example. University, Yom Nisuim. You know, you can't do in marriage that all the year will be like an anniversary. You do special party, you go with your wife. But you understand when you do it, it affects the continuum of the year. It affects the kesher, the relationship. And like this, Beit Avraha LaNefesh, 10 days to bring our soul to the highest level has a goal by itself. And as a sikum, we saw 7 answers. The first answer we saw that it's a new beginning. We start from the beginning in a certain way, tshuva. We need a new beginning that also, if afterwards we won't stay in the same level, we'll still stay in a reasonable place. The second answer we saw that when you want to change, start with 1 day. Hayomim bekolot ishmao, start with 10 days. A third answer we saw that Hashem helps us, he's close to us, and because of this, we can succeed more on those 10 days. A fourth answer we said, the palace example, that you are trying to discover your real power on a Aseret Yemei Tshuva, and maybe then you discover that there are no walls, no animals, and this is your real power. The fifth answer we said, that maybe all the year we are not in the right way. All the year it's like a tachposet, a costume of Purim. Aseret Yemei Tshuva is our natural way. And if Hashem gave us mitzvot, he gave it, that it will be good for us in a natural way. And we gave the example of healthy food, that when you don't eat healthy, you feel that healthy food is not tasty and not good, but really, healthy food is the right thing for you, and also the mitzvot are the natural thing for you. The sixth answer, we said that on a certain Yemei Tshuva, we are trying to understand what is the dream. What is the goal? Hasheifa, let's say right. Nesim legalot et hachalom. Et hamatara. What is the goal? What is the dream? And to be in a place that we are trying to feel what is the dream, this is an important thing for everyone. And Beit Avraha LaNefesh, this last thing, to have like a hotel for our soul, that also if you won't continue in the same level, this has a goal by itself. And because of this, I think that two things that we have to work on those 10 days. One thing is to try to take every year something small that we are saying, this is our goal for this year, but also to try to be tzaddik, also in things that are not realistic, to try to daven no lashon hara, to be nice for everyone, not to be angry. Maybe some of the things we'll discover that we can continue in the continuous of the year, but also if we cannot continue, if we brought our soul 10 days to this higher level, it's important and it will have an effect on all the year. And I want to end with saying slichot, ata moshel begeut hayam besog alav ata teshavchem. We say that Hashem is praising the waves of the sea. Why? Baal Shem Tov explains, the waves are going up, up, up and down. And then they go up and down and up and down. Although they went down again and again, they have koach and strength to go up again. Every one of us failed in his life. Aseret Yemei Tshuva teaches us, Yehudi, af pam lo mityayesh. You never give up. You go again and again and again. In the end, you succeed. And also now we are in special days and corona and not easy. But we know, Bezrat Hashem, all those difficult things, we bring them to a higher level, and Be'ezrat Hashem, we bring ourselves, our soul, Am Yisrael, and all the world to a higher, more moral, and more close to Hashem after the corona. As Be'ezrat Hashem, שתהיה לכולם שנה טובה, שמחה ומוצלחת.
יישר כוח.
Thank you.